Today we're going to be talking about making Lightroom run faster. I'll be sharing with you in this short video all the tactics, settings and tricks that I use to get Lightroom to run super fast even on my old laptop. So, cue the funky title sequence. We don't really have a funky title sequence. Not yet, anyway. Hey people, welcome back. Glad to have you with me. Today we're going to be talking about Lightroom and how to make it faster. So I was having a conversation with a guy on a forum thing on Reddit, and he was saying, is it possible to get Lightroom to run fast even on a sort of old low-spec laptop? Well, that's exactly what I'm doing. So let's have a look at a few simple settings that we can do straight off the bat just to get us going. So let's jump straight into Lightroom, shall we?
Right.
Let's have a look here. So under File, we can go Optimize Catalog, and it will tell you the last time that you did it, and you can press Optimize, and it will spin through and do that. Now that's great if you've been using it for a while, and if you're brand new to Lightroom, it's not really going to help too much. But if you are brand new, never fear, because you're probably in a better place, because I can show you how to set up your file structure, and that really helps. So there's one other quick thing that we can just do, just to check, under Lightroom Preferences, under Performance, we just want to make sure that this Use Graphics Processor is enabled. Now, I think it's enabled by default. So there's a couple of very quick things that we can do just to get us going. We're going to have a little look in a bit more detail, and then after we've done some of those tweaks, I can talk to you about the main thing that really is going to speed up Lightroom for you. But first, let's quickly spin through and have a look at one more thing. Under Catalog Settings, just want to check that we've got our standard preview size. I've set this to auto. That just happens to be the resolution of the Retina screen on the MacBook. You just certainly don't want to be on something, say, over the resolution. What would be the point in that? And I've got a low preview quality. And then you can choose about when to discard these one-to-one previews, because they take up a lot of memory. They are crucial, and I'll show you how to build those. They are absolutely essential. I found that I did have it set on 1 week, and that wasn't enough for me. By the time I get into getting into the nitty-gritty of doing some edits, I'm already past a week. So normally after a couple of weeks, I don't really need them anymore. So I've just got them after 30 days. So boom, that's us done with software. Well, almost. There's one more thing, but that's I'll have to come back to that. And what I want to talk about now is external disks, because the one thing that's really going to speed up using Lightroom on, say, a laptop like mine, is by getting everything off of the laptop and freeing up some space. Now, all the images, I will put my Lightroom catalog and all the files, all the raw files, etc., they will go on a super fast SSD, and I will simply Velcro that to the back of my machine, and it becomes part of my machine. I take it with me, and I kind of treat my laptop and its external drives as my Lightroom sort of editing machine, and it's all condensed. So the other way of getting things off of the laptop is by using something like this. Now these are modern marvel, really. I mean, they're very cheap. They cost you 20 odd bucks. It's 128 gig USB 3 little thumb drive. Now, I'll put links in the description, and I don't want to go into too much detail, but I'm going to make another video about storage for the photographer, and I will go into how to check the speeds on things like that. I will show you how to build one of these. You don't really need any tools for all of those. I think it's a bit too much to put into this video. So let's just assume, for argument's sake, that you have a fast SSD already, let's go back into the computer and I'll just show you how I've set this up. So let's have a quick look at my main hard drive of the computer. As I said, it's 120 gig. There is still 40 and a half left. So we're looking, you want to try and have around, say, 30 to 40% free at all times, just for optimum performance, and I've just about got that. This is the external SSD I have Velcro to the back of my computer at all times. So in here we've got 160 gig spare. So I'll come back to that. Inside I just have my catalog with my backups, and smart previews and everything's in there. All of my work are in these folders. And I keep my presets should I need those. I can just basically rip this. Say my computer broke, for instance. I could just take this drive off and plug it into someone else's computer. Download Lightroom through my Creative Cloud account, and I'm back up and running. And then this one is the little thumb drive that sticks in the side. And all of those will get time machined onto an external drive. And that's about it. Let's just fire up Lightroom. I'll show you the final little tweak that we need to do. It is under file handling, and we want to change the camera raw cache settings, or cache. I'm not sure how you would say it in America. I think this when it ships is 4 gig. They might have changed that to about 20 now, but really you want at least 100. So basically I'm using my external SSD that's Velcroed to the outside of my computer as a fast cache, and I'm assigning as much as, not as much as possible because I've got a bit spare, and I'm getting to the point now where I just need to update that drive to a terabyte, and I'm just kind of, I'm a cheapskate, I'm just waiting for the price to come down. So effectively you want to allocate as much as possible onto the fastest drive that you can get away with, really. That is about it for settings. I'll just have a look at when we go to import now, because these settings combined with having your images and catalog on this external drive are pretty much the secret to having a fast install of Lightroom. So let's just look at randomly importing these images. Up here in build previews, we definitely want to go for one-to-one previews. If you remember, those are the things that get discarded after on my computer after 30 days. On your computer, if you've got a smaller external drive, you can do them after a week or after a day, really, if you like. Don't worry if you don't do this right now, because you can do it later. But I always put build one-to-one previews, and I build smart previews, which might seem a bit weird. I build them, they get saved on the external drive. So if I need to, I can pull the smart previews and the catalog off and place that somewhere on, say, on my computer's hard drive for a temporary measure if I wanted to go and do editing on the fly where I didn't want to have the external drives plugged in. The thing is, I always do have those plugged in, and I don't really care about battery power and stuff like that. So let's just cancel that. I won't do it right now. I won't import these right now. So in the library module, if we have these one-to-one previews, we can pretty much look at full screen and we can spin through them super fast. There is no real delay. Quite like this image. There's no real delay when we're looking at images, and I'm currently running Premiere Pro on this tiny little laptop, and I'm also doing a screen record, and I have Lightroom open, so it will actually go quicker than this. Click my face.
Click my face.